Amazing. Now, let's test first, what did Joseph Smith say about God? What did Joseph Smith say about God? Who is God? That's how you witness to a Mormon. We stick to really basic issues. Who is God? How do I come to know God? Who is God and how do I come to know Him? Mormonism teaches the existence of many gods. Many gods. Mormons will tell you, am I right? They'll tell you, they'll say, we only believe in one God of this earth. That's the caveat they put on it. We only believe in one God of this earth. Mormons teach the existence of many gods. Joseph Smith in History of the Church, Volume 6, page 474, in 1844. Listen to Joseph Smith, Mormon prophet. I will preach on the plurality of gods. I have selected this text for that express purpose. I wish to declare I have always and in all congregations, when I have preached on the subject of the deity, that's God, it has been the plurality of gods. I have always declared God to be a distinct personage, Jesus Christ, a separate and distinct personage from God the Father, and that the Holy Ghost was a distinct personage and a spirit. And these three constitute three distinct personages and three gods. Joseph Smith taught that there was not one God of this earth, there were three gods of this earth. Mormonism teaches that there are many gods. Joseph Smith, in the King Follett Discourse, 2 months before his gunfight at Carthage Jail, he said, in the beginning, the head of the gods called a council of the gods. And they came together and concocted and prepared a plan to create the world and to people it. In Mormonism, there's not just many gods, there's actually a council of gods that came together to make this earth. A council of gods. This goes against all biblical teaching. In Deuteronomy 6:4 is the basic affirmation of all Christians and Jews. Deuteronomy 6:4, the person asks Jesus, he says, Master, what's the greatest commandment in the law? Jesus selects as the greatest commandment in the law, Deuteronomy 6:4. Shema Israel, Yahweh Eloheinu, Yahweh Echad. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. There is only one God. Open your Bibles to Isaiah chapter 43, verse 10. Powerful verse. And just so you know, guys, listen. I could give you a lot of verses this morning, but I want to try to give you the jewels. Now, all of God's Word is precious. Every word is pure. But I'm going to give you today, guys, the verses that I've given my Mormon friends and Mormons at the temple, Mormon bishops, Mormon missionaries, that I've given them out doing street evangelism. I've seen crowds of people surrounding us while we do evangelism, and I've seen these verses go out and mouths totally stop. Because when God speaks, that's the end of the argument. Isaiah 43:10, near the end of part of the verse there, God says, before me there was no God formed, neither shall there be after me. God says there was no God formed before me, neither shall there be after me. He says in Isaiah 44:6 and 44:8, God says, I am the first, I am the last. Besides me, there is no God. God asks a question. Listen, is God all-knowing? Yes, He is, right? God is all-knowing. And your Mormon friends will agree to that. God is all-knowing. Here's what the all-knowing God says. He says in Isaiah 44:8, is there a God besides me? Indeed, there is no other God. I know not one. Joseph Smith says in the beginning, the head of the gods called the council of the gods. And they came together and concocted and prepared a plan to create the world and to people it. Mormonism teaches that God has not always been God. Listen to Joseph Smith. He's talking about us. Listen to this here. He says, I will prove that the world is wrong by showing what God is. I'm going to inquire after God, for I want you all to know Him and to be familiar with Him. God Himself was once as we are now and is an exalted man and sits enthroned in yonder heavens. That is the great secret. Say if you were to see Him today, you would see Him like a man in form, like yourselves in all the person, image, and very form as a man. It is necessary that we should understand the character and being of God and how He came to be so. For I'm going to tell you how God came to be God. We've imagined and supposed that God was God from all eternity. I will refute that idea and take away the veil so that you may see. Joseph Smith taught that God has not been God for all eternity. In Mormonism, God has a father who had a father who has a father who has a father. It's an infinite regression of gods. In Mormonism, there is no eternal God. There is an infinite regression of gods. God has not always been God. In Mormonism, God is a big man. He has a body of flesh and bones as tangible as yours. What does Jesus say? God is spirit. And the only person that ever defined for us what spirit is the Lord Jesus. So we should listen to him. In the upper room, he says to the disciples, he says, "Here I am. It is I myself. Handle me and see. Spirit does not have flesh and bone as you see me have." God is spirit. Spirit does not have flesh and bone. Mormonism teaches that God has not always been God. What does God say of himself? In Psalm 90, verse 2, he says, "From everlasting to everlasting, thou art God." It literally says, "From eternity into eternity, thou art God." The God of the Bible is the eternal God. There was never a point in time where God came into existence. God is the creator of time and space. He is the eternal one. God's name, Yahweh, comes from the Hebrew verb to be, achya. It means, "I am, I was, I will ever be." God's name itself says he's the eternal God, that he has no beginning. In Mormonism, Mormonism teaches that you can become a God one day yourself. In Mormonism, there's a view of exaltation. When I say to you as a believer, what's your salvation? What is the good news? It's that you're going to heaven, right? That your sins are forgiven. That I've been acquitted. I've gone before God's courts now. And I've been acquitted of my sins forever. That Jesus took all my sins on the cross, and that his righteousness is mine. That God charged to me the righteousness of himself when he came and died for me. He charged to me his righteousness. In Mormonism, salvation is exaltation. It's going from one degree to another and becoming a god one day, a god of your own planet. Ladies, you get to be eternally pregnant. And you and your husband will populate a planet just like this one. That is what happened to the God of this earth, and that's what you get to do. Mormonism teaches that you become a God one day yourself. Here then, this is King Follett Discourse again. King Follett Discourse. Here then is eternal life, to know the only wise and true God, and you've got to learn to become gods yourselves. And to be kings and priests to God, the same as all gods have done before you. What's amazing is the perversion of this text. Listen to this, and just maybe some of you guys will catch this. Here then is eternal life, to know the only wise and true God. That sound familiar? It's awfully familiar. Sounds like Jesus. Jesus said, "Here then is eternal life, to know the only wise and true God and Jesus Christ."